Well, welcome to one of the busiest, biggest metropolitan areas in the country. Charles County, Maryland, the Washington, D.C. area, the 2016 Bassmaster Elite Series Econo Lodge Bassmaster Elite event on the Potomac River. Welcome to the Toyota Bassmaster Studios. Tommy Sanders here with Mark Zona. 8 years since they've been there, but this is a major tournament venue anyway, and everybody's got some expectations.
Right? Well, yeah, there's no doubt about it, Tommy. And really, if you ride up and down this river and you see all the landmarks, you get a vibe of the history of the Potomac River. But in bass fishing terms, really, the last several decades, this is one of the best venues that we go to. But that being said, the Potomac River is a monster. It is a monster. And here's the best way to put it: when you come here, you are either on them or you're not.
Well, on day number one, there was no question about who was on them. The one-time winner, third-year man with the Bassmaster Elite Series, Justin Lucas.
Five fish for Justin Lucas. 20 pounds, 4 ounces. 20 pounds and 4 ounces. Justin Lucas hammers him here on day number one.
I can't say that there's a key time. It's just, I prefer low tide. I think every fisherman does. It pulls them out of where they live and, you know, puts them on pinpoint spots. But I tried to find an area that was productive on all different tides and might have found it. I mean, it's a pretty special little area. I don't know if it can hold up for 3 days. Hopefully I'll have it to myself and hopefully it'll keep producing.
We will break down this place at length throughout the course of this hour. Safe to say, though, he's not running away and hiding from anybody.
Oh,
right?
No, absolutely fishing one of the most well-known spots on the Potomac River. Not only that, he is literally within a quarter mile of Washington, D.C.
It's a weird spot because there's a point right there, and on an outgoing tide, it really just creates an eddy right here, so the current almost always seems to be blowing in.
Yes.
It's just not strong, obviously, when it's going out because it's just kind of a back current. So when the tide comes in, it really starts moving through here.
Got it.
I think overall, it's just going to be a lot tougher day. We got a really strong south wind this morning. I think it kind of blew through the night and it's really got the water pushed up right now. So
That's right.
When that tide comes back in, it's really going to create a lot of current. See what I mean about the tide? I don't know for sure what's best tide, but I'd say this one right now is working pretty good. There's one. Good one, too.
Okay, now I have to do this, Tommy Sanders.
Yep.
He made a comment right there. He said overall he felt that this was going to be a lot tougher day.
Sure.
Have you looked at his first 90 minutes of fishing so far?
It's kind of nonstop. I know what you're saying.
Not only that, this dock offers everything you need. It has cover, it has depth, current, and food. And really looking at day number two, he's got a pretty good shot of upsizing over his day one catch.
Unbelievable. Not moving at all. You said earlier, I'm looking for a place where it works in all kinds of tidal situations. Being from the Delta, he's a guy that would do that.
Found it.
Jeez, man. Oh, come on. Oh, my gosh. Big one. Big, big one. Come here. Yes! Yeah. That's a toad, man.
Yes, it is. Big one right there for Justin Lucas. And here's the most impressive thing. Sitting with over a 4 pound average on the Potomac River.
Yeah, how about the weigh-in? Day number two, 19 pounds and 14 ounces within 6 ounces of his 24 day one total. So Justin Lucas opening up a lead on this crowd, trying to go wire to wire, but we're just 2 days into this thing right now. We got two more days of fishing coming up on the Potomac River, a Saturday when it could get crowded. There's our top 12 after day two, and Lucas on top. Brent Ehrler, his nearest pursuer, Brosnick, also Gerald, Swindle, all those guys, Jason Christie in the race for Toyota Bassmaster Angler of the Year. It's getting thick and heavy here. We'll be back with day three.
The Bassmaster Elite at Potomac River, presented by Econo Lodge, is brought to you by Yamaha. Berkeley. Humminbird. And by Mercury.
First time since 2007 for the Bassmaster Elite Series here on the historic, to say the least, Potomac River. Washington, D.C. area, Charles County, Maryland. There's your leader after 2 days with over 40 pounds of bass. Young Justin Lucas headed to a place that, well, Mark Zona, as we take a look at our Yamaha Unlock the Lake, this is a place you can't miss. You could see it from outer space.
Absolutely. You could see it on Google Earth or any, you could literally drive to it from the road, to be honest with you. And really, Justin Lucas said, I don't know how long this boat dock, it's really a parking deck, will last. Will it last for day three and day four? And really, all he needs to catch is 10 more bass because of the quality that lives here. But every day, he's tried to expand a little bit. When I say expand, I mean, well, within 20 feet of the parking deck.
Little guy. But number one, so we'll take it. Haven't been catching them that small. Did the first day a little bit.
Well, something we have not seen so far in this event with Justin Lucas actually having to measure one.
Yeah, he's been going strong till today. Everybody's kind of hitting a wall. Slow day as well for this guy right here, one of his closest pursuers, Brent Ehrler, having his best tournament of the year so far.
Exactly right. That's your guy, Tommy Sanders.
Oh, no, he's your guy. You're the one that's always Facebook it or Google Claw or something with it.
Something
what do you call
like
it?
That, Tommy know. Sanders. Yeah. But here's an interesting analogy that Brent Ehrler said about this tournament. He has fished the Potomac River several times, and a lot of guys get in crowds where there's big populations of bass here. A lot of these grass beds will have multiple competitors. He said he's tried to get away from them, fish for less bass, but less pressured bass. Well, that being said, execution has been a big key on day three.
You know, I'm sitting at 5 or 6 pounds right now, and I told myself if I caught 8 or 10, I'd probably make the top 12 cut. For how tough the fishing is, I mean, that hurts. I haven't been catching enough big ones to not have that matter. Oh, I got three right now. Two of them are real small, and it's so annoying. I'm only gonna fish this left side for now. And then when I get farther in there, oh boy, that's a big one. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness, that was a big one. Gah! Golly. I would have made the cut with that one fish right there. Gosh dang it. Freaking big one. 3.5, 4 pounder. Gosh dang it. Would have made the cut with that one fish. That one fish only, I would have made the cut tomorrow. Gosh dang it. Four pounder. I have 5 or 6 pounds right now. Lose a 4 pounder. Would have made the cut.
Well, for sure a day Brett Ehrler would love to forget. I mean, so slow and then capped off by the loss of a really meaningful fish right there, without exaggeration. But he's maybe not doing as bad as he thinks, because for the whole field, including Justin Lucas, it's going pretty slow.
Yeah, and if you really look at what Justin Lucas has caught in this tournament so far, he's still on par to blow away the winning weights from 2006 and 2007. But with that said, his main concern was that there was enough quality bites to last him day three and day four. And he still believes they are here. He's getting plenty of bites. Everything's still going okay. But he's just missing the quality that we saw in the first 2 days of competition.
It's really hard to say why there's smaller ones today. I just think, you know, the big ones don't bite. I don't think that they've left. I've still gotten plenty of bites from bait and everything else on the end of my hook. So I know that they're, you know, there's still bait in the area. And I don't know. I really don't. I mean, that's, like I said, I didn't even know these fish were here until the first day of the tournament. So this is all I have. After starting here on day one, if I didn't catch them, I was just gonna go start practicing. There's one.
good one too. Oh, come on, baby. Come on. Come on, come on, come on. That one helps, man.
Well, and for the first time in this tournament, Justin Lucas calling an audible and actually heading back downriver and making an enormous late day call. First one we've seen not from that spot. Let's take you to the weigh-in, day number three, and Keith Combs very much in Toyota Bassmaster Angler of the Year race, fifth place after day three. Exactly. Keep your eye on Jason Christie. Big things happen on final days with this guy. Fourth place, 45 pounds, 6 ounces. Brent Ehrler, we saw the kind of day he was having out there, one kind of frustration after another, manages to bring in enough to remain in third place after day three. One of the best shallow water fishermen on the Bassmaster Elite Series, having another fantastic year. Bill Lowen, second place after day three. One guy left to weigh in, the one who knocked out 40-plus pounds over the first 2 days. Guy trying to take it wire to wire for his second Bassmaster Elite Series win, Justin Lucas.
Five fish today, looking for 7-2 to take the lead. 12 pounds, 15 ounces, back in the lead with 53 pounds and an ounce. Justin Lucas has his second Bassmaster Elite Series title in targets and is five bites away from making that happen.
Well, Justin Lucas firmly in control, a 6-pound lead after 3 days of fishing on the Potomac and 1 day left to go. And these 12, the only ones remaining, Bill Lowen and Brett Ehrler in pursuit. Christie as well, and Keith Combs, two big players in Toyota Bassmaster Angler of the Year. Just one more regular season event after this one, and everyone at this point of the season has a better idea of what a win could do for them.
It's just been one of them phenomenal weeks where every decision that I make works out, and hopefully it'll continue.
Anything can happen. I mean, I could catch a 17, 18-pound bag and have a chance to win.
A win here to me would be huge, especially after the season I've had. I've been down and out this whole year. To win this tournament would be probably the biggest thing I've ever done in my career.
A win anytime means a lot. You get $100,000 and you get a blue trophy, and I think the blue trophy does more than the $100,000. You know, to win here would be awesome, but I can't lie to you, to win anytime is awesome. Woo!
The fourth day is championship day. 12 anglers on that day, so 12 boats ready to go. On this final day, Econo-Lodge Bassmaster Elite event on the Potomac River. And each one of these anglers knows what's at stake here. We've been through that before, and each of them knows that he's going to have to do something pretty special on this final day to catch our leader. Justin Lucas is the man with a 6-pound lead heading into the final day. He's not worried about his strategy. I think it's pretty well mapped out.
Hope we can get it done today, man. One more day. Never led a tournament wire to wire, so just a crazy feeling, and having such a big lead is it's a comfortable feeling, but a sickening feeling at the same time, because you don't want to let it slip away. So I'm gonna work as hard as I ever have before. I know this opportunity doesn't come around often at all. You know, I've been fishing professionally for 7 years and I've never been in this position. So it's a really rare spot to be in, and I want to take full advantage.
Well, no big secret, we're gonna head right back up to Washington, D.C. Tommy Sanders, I call this Kirk Cousins country right here.
That's right.
Exactly.
It's
country.
Redskin talk.
Exactly right.
Yes.
Justin Lucas, all of his chips are in on this parking deck.
I'm gonna try and start just like I did the very first morning. Same routine. Yesterday I mixed it up and started from the other end, and not a suspicious or superstitious guy, but maybe that was the direction they wanted the bait pulled that morning, so we'll keep that going. You know, my game plan is definitely to go back to where it's all been going down for me. If I have to scramble and run around and try and catch something, I will. I'm gonna have one or two more spinning rods on the deck and try some really tricky little things that, you know, I grew up throwing in California, little wacky rig type stuff or whatever. I'm definitely gonna try and show them everything I can before I have to leave that dock.
Number one, if I can get him in. Yes.
There's one.
Thanks for playing, bro.
I love fishing tide. What I love about tide is you can go from having a bad day really quick, number two, to having a good day really quick. Just the fact that there's feeding windows every single day,
yes,
because there's current all throughout a tidal system.
All right. They're biting this morning. Back at it, man.
There's some guys that don't like it, and I'm okay with that. I hope we keep going to them, because I think some guys get out of their comfort zone in a tidal place.
Dude, I dream about dock pilings every night.
And I think just growing up on it has definitely helped keep my confidence high when we visit places like this.
Number five, I think.
We got a limit, man.
Got a limit already.
Well, Justin Lucas said after his day three performance, he needed this dock to perform one more time, and that's exactly what it did this morning.
Yeah, a lot of the questions have, or at least on their way to being erased right now, as Justin Lucas forges ahead toward trying to win this thing wire to wire over to Bill Lowen. Bill Lowen with a pretty consistent performance, 16, 13, 14, 6, and back to 16 on day number three, so it's been steady for him so far.
Big key this week for me has been, if you notice, I'm trying to keep that bait in there for a really long time and just kind of dead stick it or almost shake it around, you know, sometimes 20, 30 seconds at a time. And that's really hard to fish like that. But I think that's been why this week a lot of guys have missed some of the fish in the areas, because, you know, we just have a tendency to fish too fast. So definitely by soaking my bait around the cover this week has been huge. I've had very few fish eat my bait while I've been swimming it along. Nice. There's an old pipeline or something running across there that I found yesterday at low tide. You noticed I started pitching out in the middle of the creek. Fish was right on that old pipeline. So if there's ever a tip, pay attention to what's out there in the middle of the lake at low tide. Come back on when it's got some water over top of it, maybe at high tide, get you a bite.
Bill Lowen, amazing career. You associate him with places like this, creeks and rivers sort of in the north and eastern part of the country, but he does well everywhere, believe me, just like this guy, Jason Christie.
No doubt about it. And Christie, for the first time this tournament, really laying his frog down and going to work with different baits this morning, throwing a vibrating jig and a small shallow diving crankbait. That being said, the meat that he has put in his live well have all come on a frog, and he's waiting for the right time.
Well, we might be caught up with Lucas now. So we need a 10 pounder, 12 pounder to have a chance. We're gonna catch some biggins on a frog. I mean, I don't know if big enough to catch him. He's gonna have to have a bad day.
Yes, it's fine.
Skinny, that's the first skinny one I've caught all week. You know what, he's a lot bigger than the one I had in there.
Oh, we've talked about this plenty of times. Last day shenanigans by this guy are not unknown. He can pull off some amazing things. He's got to pull off something pretty amazing today.
Now, we've seen the weight really change this week. I mean, somebody might catch 17 and then 8. So anything can happen. I mean, if I go out and catch 17 or 18, somebody else can fall.
The Bassmaster Elite at Potomac River, presented by Econo Lodge, is brought to you by Minn Kota. Triton Boats. And by Nitro.
Bassmaster Elite Series for the first time since 2007. Here on the famous Potomac River, this is the final day and 12 anglers on this final day in this legendary fishing place where if you're into grass, if you're into vegetation, you are in heaven here. The view from above as we watch Brent Ehrler trying to do what he can to get back in the picture for a win.
It's just tough fishing. You know, it's just it's a tough place to fish, but I mean, based on the weights of what everyone's catching, I mean, it's awesome. I mean, there's great weights, you know, a lot of fish being caught. It's an absolute grind, but you know, at the end of the day, the five fish limits that are being brought in are a lot better than what I'd expected. Oh, there we go. Not a giant, but that's a keeper. I'll take it. Two-pounder.
Well, if you ever want to know why the Potomac River has survived through the years, it's that right there. What a great aerial of all of that vegetation in this river. Basically, that is what keeps the population alive. Checking out a keeper right there from Brent Ehrler. Going to head back upriver now with Justin Lucas. A solid limit in the boat, and really only looking for about one or two more big bites on his drop shot.
God, that's a good one if it's a bass. It is. Come here, dude. I hear you. Yes! Woohoo! Yes!
That's the biggest fish of the tournament.
Oh my gosh. I love this fish right here. Oh. That's a $100,000 fish right there, man. That's a $100,000 fish. Woo! I freaking love the Potomac River. I love this place. Oh my gosh. Are you kidding me? That's what I just called out, the 5-pounder. Get one more of those and just take it easy.
Justin Lucas looking more and more solid with each passing hour here this final day on the Potomac River. Justin Lucas now in his third year with the Bassmaster Elite Series. Already has one win, won it last season near the start of the season. His home waters, the Sacramento River, now 3,000 miles away. He's looking at a second one. Winning on the Elite Series, it's a standalone thing. Now it's been going on for more than a decade, and it's not easy to win.
Exactly right, Tommy Sanders. And here's some sweet, sweet stats, my friend. Look at the young anglers that have won once or twice on the Bassmaster Elite Series. A lot of big names that have not. One of those anglers looking for yet his second win, another young angler, Keith Combs.
Last year I had a good year, no wins, and this year has been a very solid year for me, but no wins. So, you know, I had four top 12s last year, and I'm gonna have four so far this year. It seems like every time I get in that top 12, there's always, like the Justin Lucas is this week, you know, he's got a 7-pound lead. There's always that one guy that even if he has a subpar day, he's gonna be tough to catch. I'm just gonna go fishing and just concentrate on the areas where I've had big bites. I know what I have to catch.
Keith Combs driving home the point even more how hard it is to win out here. He's also trying to win Toyota Bassmaster Angler of the Year, and you look at a fantastic report card there with one exception.
Exactly right, and that exception at Bull Shoals, that 90th place finish is really what has stopped him from blowing our Angler of the Year race away.
Absolutely would be a completely different story. Otherwise, he's in a position behind and 37 points behind Gerald Swindle now, who's got his fate in his own hands. Tharp and Hackney, both long shots to make it to the top spot by the end of the year. But again, anything can happen. Keith Combs, super consistent and a great season.
Oh, gosh. That's a good one. That's a good one.
We'll take that kind right there all day long.
Keith Combs, one of the few whose weights have actually been improving day to day throughout this tournament. We're going to go to another guy now whose weights have been going slightly the other direction.
Exactly right. Jason Christie really says he thinks he has found the window where these big fish, these giant Potomac River bass, will eat that frog. But so far today, zero bites on
it. Dude, I've caught six keepers, and I ain't caught one with frog. I mean, that's like total opposite of what it's been. I've been lucky to pull up in a few of the right places. It's about decisions, making the right decision at the right time, especially on this pond. Probably more crucial this tournament than any other.
Big one. I didn't get a good hook in it. Come here.
Giant. Come back here to the back. Just stay balled up in the grass. Just stay balled up in the grass. Oh, just come here. Come here. Gotcha. Look at that. That makes up some ground. Catch my breath, I'm about to pass out.
Don't pass out, you still got a long way to go because everybody on this final day, as expected, is chasing Justin Lucas. Welcome to the Shell Rotella Bassmaster Garage, trying to break it down a little more. And everybody catching them a lot better on this final day, Mark Zona, including Jason Christie.
Yeah, really catching them in a big way on this final day. And if you kind of rewind days two and days three, listening to leaders like Brent Ehrler, Jason Christie, there was so much traffic in their area. Just a lot of noise, a lot of everything going on. And really on this final day, it's quiet, it's peaceful. These are very heavily pressured bass, heavily pressured tidal bass. Mm-hmm. And well, here's the best way to put it on this final day. It is a different playing field.
All right, with that different playing field, let's go back to Jason Christie and see if he can cut the margin, maybe a little more.
That'll help. Dude, that's freaking catching them.
Jason Christie, what you might call the start, maybe the start of a turnaround on this final day. Not too much time left, though, as we quickly head back up the river toward the metro area and Justin Lucas.
There's another one. Oh, a little cold, too. I'd say this spot's back on.
It is a good one.
Come here.
What do you say?
That's a done deal. That's a done deal. Might as well, right? Dude, they're back.
Another solid call right there for Justin Lucas, and that's definitely going to be the Skeeter Boat's Taste the Bait this week. His boat was sitting over about 7 foot of grass, and there was probably 4 to 6 feet of water under that dock. There was a lot of debris, a lot of old pile. It looked like there was a hubcap right there, Tommy Sanders. And what he would do is take that drop shot, that little 6-inch hand pour worm, throw it under the dock and work it to the edge, those outer pilings, and it kind of acted like, well, it just blocked current and that's where all the bigger ones were.
What's crazy is, you know, I know that the first morning, if I would have fished halfway down this dock and not had 2-3 pound bites, I would have left and I wouldn't be here. That's what's crazy. You know, maybe, who knows, if I was pitching a jig and didn't get those bites. I mean, that's why it was important that I was throwing a drop shot on this spot or not something else. Here's a fish. Good one, too. Real good one, I think. Yep. Boom. That'll help. Tell my wife, mom, dad, stepdad, brothers, all my family that's watching, this week's been for you guys right here. It's awesome. Wish you guys were all here, but I'm thinking about you and love you guys.
Having a T-I-M-E, Tommy. Start doing the dedications. You know kind of what's coming up next, or at least has a good shot at coming up next. Justin Lucas still putting the weight in the boat relentlessly on this final day, trying to win it wire to wire. Bassmaster Elite event on the Potomac River. This is day number 4, the final day. Only 12 anglers left. Justin Lucas with a 6-pound lead to start the day, and maybe expanding that lead right now. As far as margin of victory goes, pretty high bar to get over, Mark Zona.
No doubt about it. If you look at some of those victories right there, they were all victories where guys were doing something different or getting away from the mass, getting away from other anglers. And really, that is exactly what Justin Lucas has done in this event. Another angler that's kind of got off the beaten path, usually does in an Elite Series tournament, Bill Lowen. And Bill Lowen has milked this area for everything it's worth, and actually still catching them with only, well, a few hours left on this final day.
Oh, God. Yeah! Woo! Gotta love that little pipeline. That's the kind we need. Couple more of those, game on.
Well, if he knew what was going on with our leader there, he might up that estimate just a little bit. Justin Lucas, after falling a little bit on day 3, on point today.
There it is. I don't know how big he is yet. Oh, he's probably a good one. Oh, yeah. Come here. Got him. Yes. That's game. That's over. Yes. Dude, a weightless bait, like in 10 feet of water. Takes forever to get down there, but that's what you get. They never see it down there. Give me some, dude. We haven't high-fived all week. There we go. That's what we're getting rid of. Thanks, buddy. We got over 17 now. That's a fish. Oh my gosh, dude. That's a giant. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. Oh, got him. Yes. Best day yet, I'm pretty sure. 2.5, all 3s and bigger. Yes, that's it. We should go back now.
Justin Lucas gonna call it a day and actually head to the weigh-in early. Gonna head over to Jason Christie, sees one cruising. This is one of the most interesting catches we have seen on the Bassmasters all year.
Dadgummit. Yeah! In the mouth. Sight fishing.
Dude, that's just one of them days. Yeah, goosebumps. There's something crazy happening. I don't know what it is. I should have got him the first time. He got the end of my worm. Now, it just so happened I had a bad mamma in my pocket. Put it on real fast and got her. Dude, we got him.
Jason Christie, you heard him say it. It's just one of these days, and certainly a day that's bigger and better than the one that came before it. Same story for this guy here, Brent Ehrler.
Absolutely, and Brent Ehrler, kind of pretty much the same story as Jason Christie. Not as big as a day by far, but a very solid performance after day three where you're just seeing a different Potomac River, and you know, you can't stress this enough that really, the lack of fishing pressure has to be the reason these guys have just blown their doors out.
There we go. Got three decent fish right now. Two good ones, one just okay one. You know, we have plenty of day left. If I can time a couple things right now, you know, I could get up to that, close to that 14, 15 pound mark, I think.
It's a nice one. Yes!
Oh boy. Oh boy. Look at that. Hook's about to fall off. Don't you flop. Don't you flop.
Yes!
That's number five.
Brent Ehrler just having a whole lot more fun on this day than he did on day number three. He's going to have a whole bunch more fun to get in the league of our man Justin Lucas, who's going to make good on his call he made a few minutes ago. He's going to knock it off for the day and head for the dock.
Hey, Tripp, how's it going? Hey, I'm back at the dock, and I just wanted to make sure that I can get iced. Yeah. Okay. All right, cool. Okay, thank you very much.
Did I sign it, Potomac River champ, yet?
Go ahead.
That might be bad luck. I'll get you afterwards. Okay. I gotta make sure.
Okay.
No other way to put it. It's just the end of a perfect day for Justin Lucas, the kind every professional bass angler dreams about. Just relax, kick back, and wait for weigh-in time. More fishing to come, though. Final day's not done yet.
Presented by Econo Lodge is brought to you by Toyota. GoPro. Skeeter Boats. And by Hook.
Final moments of fishing on the Potomac. Our leader, Justin Lucas, has put his rod down. He thinks he's done his damage for the day. 11 other guys still going after it, including this man, Brent Ehrler.
Brent Ehrler been kind of bouncing back and forth, bladed jig and a Yamamoto swimming Senko, and starting to work on a very solid stringer.
That's a big one. That's a big one. Get in here. Yes! Oh my goodness, look at that one. Yes! I watched him eat it. Oh my goodness. Woo! Oh my goodness. Wait till you see this call. Oh my goodness. How's that right there for a call? Look at that. Oh my goodness, that's a nice one.
Brent Ehrler and his action-packed final day continues here on the Potomac River. His day as good as it is, not as good as this man's. Jason Christie totally on fire on Sunday.
Come out of there. That looked like a good one. Oh. It's got a big tail.
freaking begging. Come here. Yeah. Woo!
I don't know what's happening today, but as I was saying earlier, we're not gonna leave. We're gonna stay right here. Hey, we freaking got them. I may not ever catch them, but we got them today. For the Potomac. I mean, I ain't got nothing in there less than four. Dude, that's, I don't even know what to say. Something's happened today, and I got goosebumps right now thinking about it.
Well, in any other Bassmaster Elite Series tournament, this is probably one of the most impressive final day stringers we have ever covered. And unfortunately, Jason Christie playing big catch-up ball, but the one thing that he did on this final day, he made sure Justin Lucas had to catch him.
Underscores how hard it is to win against the best in the world on the Bassmaster Elite Series. Now, everybody back in place at Smallwood State Park, ready to make it official and have our way in to decide our winner for the week.
Oh boy, he has got a load. Looking for 14-7 to take the lead. 23 pounds and an ounce! The biggest bag of the tournament belongs to Jason Christie. Let's keep him rolling through from Newport Beach, California. Get loud for GoPro angler Brent Ehrler. He's 22-15 to take the lead. 17 pounds and 3 ounces. With 62 pounds and 12 ounces, Brent Ehrler moves into second place currently. Makes a paycheck 75% of the time on the Bassmaster Elite Series. An 8-time Geico Bassmaster Classic qualifier from Brookville, Indiana, Dollar Bill Lowen. 5 fish for Bill Lowen today, looking for 21 pounds and 5 ounces. To take the lead here at the Potomac River Bassmaster Elite, presented by Econo Lodge. 13-13 moves into third place with 61 pounds even. He has led this event since day number one. A 2-time Geico Bassmaster Classic qualifier. 5 FLW Tour wins. 1 Elite Series win. Looking to win Elite Series events in back-to-back years. Alabama, Justin Lucas. Started today with 53 pounds and an ounce. He's looking for 15 pounds and 7 ounces to become a 2-time Elite Series champion. 19 pounds, 13 ounces. Justin Lucas lays the lumber to the Potomac River, becoming a 2-time Bassmaster Elite Series champion. 72 pounds and 14 ounces. We started with 107, cut it down to 50, 12 went out today, and now there is one. Your champion, the 2016 Potomac River Bassmaster Elite, presented by Econo Lodge, Justin Lucas.
Since he first joined the Elite Series not very many years ago, there's been no doubt about the abilities of this young man. And now, with his second win in hand, Mark Zona, Justin Lucas is putting some numbers on the scoreboard to back up those expectations.
Definitely, and he's pretty modest. You know, the first day that we met him, he said, well, guys, I'm still learning. I'm not really sure that I deserve to be here. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that he does deserve to be here. And the other side of it is, that was a flawless beatdown. But with that being said, also, what Jason Christie did on this final day was one of, here's what's strange is, you look at what Justin Lucas did and you're like, man, that was one of the best single performances we've seen this year. And then you're like, heck, second place had one of the best performances.
Absolutely.
Those two anglers really, at the end of this event, were on a different playing field.
Yeah, and you look at their records over the past 3 years. Hey, Jason Christie, a top 10 every third time out, about 34 cuts out of 49 tournaments. That's unbelievable.
You're looking at 1A and 1A right there.
Absolutely.
No doubt.
The top two, it's been a real pleasure. The Potomac, we go to the last regular season event, Toyota Bassmaster Angler of the Year points race. It's closer and closer to coming to full fruition at the end of the season. We got a lot of stuff to watch when we get up there.
No doubt about it, Tommy. Here's the best way to put it. Mississippi River, then we head up into Minnesota. Get ready for them to catch them.
We're ready. We'll see you next time.